Well, the process is, you know, as far as my background in metal, I've worked in metal most of my working career, and in the millwright trade, it was putting things together. So it was basically a school, or kind of a training to build things and know how things work and how they stick together. So through the process of welding or being self-trained or self-taught so I come at it from a kind of a workman, journeyman kind of thing. I do have inspiration and I do have things that I like to see put together, but it's mostly being here every day trying to make something happen, you know, coming to at least clean the shop out to see what can be put together. So basically that's my the process of working here. The serendipitous part of it is the best. I mean, you come up with these pieces that become something. So this is just a process in the making of things. I'll be cutting a chunk off of this for another element, a yard piece. So we'll be just using a torch on this. This is part of the cutter here, cutting torch.
What kind of torch is that, Sam?
Acetylene and oxygen, pressurized oxygen, cuts through the steel. So basically oxidizes the steel, cuts through. So you just set it on there, heat it up to melting. So this torch gets at 2,100 degrees. In making things, it's part making up parts and pieces, or just using found objects also, but it's a matter of fall apart. Basically, these are parts and pieces to whatever project comes up, but of course, fabricating on the make. These scroll works will go into a railing eventually. And these other objects here, that's all parts and pieces of other projects. These will be some pedestals that will eventually be finished up. And basically it's all these gatherings for different types of work, just for the found object or assemblages. And things are just kind of tucked around here. This is as far as the process, it's a welded, blacksmith, fabricated process of working. So I'll, you know, hammer and heat and cut and weld. That's why it's making. These are all just kind of bits and pieces of all the stuff that I use. I'll show you this. This is a windblown piece that'll eventually be put together, so it's basically just in the forming stages right now. It takes shape, so things get formulated and then they sit and then worked on again. Kind of a work table here, cutting table, catch all. Cutters, thermal arts, and other tools and processes. And as far as putting stuff together, I tend to go more with the just the objects and formulated pieces that come out of just pieces that I cut and formulate and kind of reconfigure. Well, as far as the process of making things, usually it's a kind of a found object thing. I let the pieces that I find inform what the pieces will be like, and it's an ongoing process where the thing is kind of informs itself, and I pick up new pieces. But as far as doing commission work, I'll buy new material or whatever the job calls for. Making a project, so it's basically either I go into this kind of bound object mode, or I, you know, go into some drawings of this, you know, as far as project for a prospective client, I'll coordinate the project and what, sculpt it and what have you for the client. So, and I have patterns as far as making things. This was a pattern osprey for a weather vane I did for the port on top of the new band shell. So this was cut out of stainless. These patterns are used to cut out of steel or stainless or whatever. And basically it's, you know, working with a client as far as a project. But for my own things, I just kind of like that free form of letting the pieces inform how it goes up and how it's built. In the long term of my career here, it's been just a journey into finding the process and myself, and it's a work type of a thing where I'll come in and just work, and you can kind of play, but it's basically you're here trying to make it happen, regardless of how much you get done in the day, but you get into it, into the project or whatever else comes up. So I'm going to show you a process as far as the, these will be legs for a railing. So these will be involved with this also. So basically I'll use a grinder and clean that up just to kind of get some tools. Set this.
Sam, can you talk a little bit about your finishes?
Okay. You see there, a lot of it, the stuff that I find has rust on it. So I keep the rust and I use an Osmo. It's basically a converter. It converts the rust into a primer. And you can primer it and see that it will paint. So it has a nice base to it. But usually a lot of them, I'll be doing more stainless, of course, for the weather. And, so a lot of galvanizing processes as far as protecting the metals, which work on a larger projects as far as railings and just sculpture itself, as far as protecting from the weather. And some of the stuff is, you know, heavy enough as far as the rust. You just let it go, brown rust. And there's other metals, cortens, and what have you, that will deal with the weather. But, usually, as far as getting paint or getting some color into the atmosphere, the project, the benches here in Toledo was part of that. It was fun getting more color in the town. I mean, all these benches are different colors and different designs and what have you. Just always, you know, finding
process to protect it.
So it's an ongoing process
of finding ways.
Thank you.